Hi there, this is Åsa with a new process video. Today I'm making a page with a photo from a couple of weeks ago. It was in, I think it was late February, and we discovered that we had spring flowers budding in the garden. And we thought that was super early. So the title for this page will be "Already?" and question mark, exclamation mark, question mark. So this is perhaps a sign of the time that it's getting warmer and warmer. We normally don't get spring flowers until at least mid or the end of March. These are called snowdroppar. It's translated into snowdrops. If I just translate Swedish words, I don't know what you call them, but they are white flowers that they are always the ones that bloom first. We had the roe deers visiting us the other night, and I was surprised that they left these, but I think they managed to eat up all the tulip buds that we had gotten in the flower bed below our dining room window. But they left the snowdrops, and I was happy about that. I don't get mad at roe deers. I think they are beautiful creatures, so I was just surprised that they left these. The papers that I'm using are from the Kaiserkraft base coat collection. That's the ones that I'm using as layering. And the background paper, because for once I'm using a pattern paper as a background. The background paper is from the Crate Paper Flea Market collection, and it's got some kind of paint chip gradient going on there, and I think it's super beautiful. So I was happy to be able to showcase the whole paper as a background for this page. And I also think that the colors fit perfectly with the green and the white buds and the snow. So a perfect fit. And since I think that spring is a bit ugly, and until almost summer starts, then it becomes beautiful. But the start of spring, when it's just dirty and the snow is melting and it looks like yes, you know, and the small pieces of happiness are those flowers budding. So. Since I think that spring at this point is rather ugly, I thought that the base coat line matched very well, especially since it had some of that green-blue tint to it, so that I could match the background. So I just place a couple of different layers. And do you see it? I have used the silhouette again. I just found this super cute picture file on Pinterest. It's got the geotags with the different patterns in the middle, and it was one of the first cuts that I made. I actually opened up the silhouette cameo before my birthday, because it arrived a couple of days earlier, and first I thought that I would save it for my actual birthday, but hubby thought that was really silly and that only kids needed to do that, so so we opened the machine and tried it out, and since I had my birthday in the middle of the week, I didn't have time to play with it anyway, but it was fun to make those first cuts, because I was so surprised of how well it cut. And one of those geotags has the world map on it in the middle, and it cuts perfectly. It's so sweet, and it's so small, and it's so it's almost like I have never seen anything like that. Needless to say, I'm very happy with the machine. Yes, very. Back to the layout. I am mixing some modeling paste with the two different colors of paint rubber paint, and making some just dots in a couple of different places. It's nothing that really hides or gets in the way of the the actual pattern of the paper, so just the accents and give some more interest. I kept those geotags white, like a little treat to the snow there, so it gives yet another shade of white. I'm using thickers for my title, and the title will be all ready, like I told before, but that will be spelled with smaller alpha stickers, and this is the date, 28th of February, and that's the larger piece of the title, just to make the date more visible on the page, since it was rather early for flowers. So I'm just making a little grounding piece there for those numbers. Normally I would have written 02 for February, but I didn't have a zero on that thickers sheet, so it had to do with just the 2. And there's the grounding piece for the actual title that will have the word already on it, and it will be in Swedish, and it is called it's said Redan. I've been on a spending freeze for so long now that I'm quite eager to start shopping again, but at the same time I know in my heart that I have all the things that I need to play with my Silhouette Cameo for a long while, so I'm not going to shop, and I'm also going to think twice before I buy anything, because I think that I can make most of the colors and the not the patterns, but the textures that's popular at the moment. So I think that I will not have a shop stop again, but kind of think twice and maybe even more before I press the buy button. I have a couple of things that's on top of my wish list, and I want to buy marbling colors that you can use for paper, and I've been to the local art supply store, and they have it in their list of things, but they didn't have it in stock, so I had a hubby go back there and ask, because it's closer to his job, and he's been there twice and they still haven't gotten it, so I think that I will need to order that on the internet. And I'd also like a box of watercolor paints. I've seen one on Simon Says Stamp, and it's got 32 colors in one box, just like an ordinary watercolor box, and it's really a nice price, I think, and you get all those different colors, and you don't need to blend them. And the shipping to Sweden from Simon Says Stamps is totally ridiculous, so I've found a similar box here in Sweden, but it's in shops that have no other supplies that I want to buy, so I will put that on hold as well. Then I realized that I'm running out of albums, so I will have to order, and that's a must have. I have to order a couple of more albums and page protectors, and so that's perhaps the first thing that I will need to buy. I'm finishing this page with some stamping. I stamp Fun Find around the photo block, and you see also that I have written the name of those particular flowers onto the photo. So this is the finished page. thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you here again in my channel soon. Take care. This is Åsa. Bye.